we are trying to be like Christ, but we're all sinful people. You know, we struggle with selfishness and anger. We struggle with pride. We struggle when we make an error at shortstop and have to come off the field and lay it on, you know. And it's also a sin to use the Lord's name in vain when the Padres lose to the Phillies. But that's something else. Anyway. Yeah.
Sorry, I had an itch.
But on a serious note. Thank you. Payson, take Lauren to be your wedded wife, to cherish in love and in friendship, in strength and in weakness, in success and in disappointment, to love her faithfully today, tomorrow, and as long as the two of you shall live.
I do.
Good answer. Now, Lauren. Do you, Lauren, take Payson to be your wedded husband, to cherish in love and in friendship, in strength and in weakness, in success and in disappointment, to love him faithfully today, tomorrow, and as long as the two of you shall live?
I do.
So now we're going to exchange our rings. Now, before we do that, just to give you an insight of the reason why we exchange rings, it's an outward symbol of a spiritual bond that's never ending. So we're going to go ahead and start with our ring ceremony. Repeat after me, Payson. Lauren.
Lauren.
Oh, bless me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And faithfulness to you.
And faithfulness to you. Thanks. I need to remind you, Greg.
All right. By the same token, Lauren, you may place a ring on the finger of your groom. Repeat after me. Payson.
Payson.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And faithfulness to you.
And faithfulness to you.
I've been waiting a really long time to do this, but I cannot wait to officially just say, by the power vested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. Yeah!